Joseph and his brethren. In due time, Joseph revealed himself to his brethren. After speaking sternly to them, he made them a feast, sending them portions from his own table. They were astonished and fearful, wondering what the kindness signified. Then, sending away the Egyptian servants, Joseph made himself known to his brethren, assuring them of his forgiveness, and that God had caused all of his trying experiences to work out for his good, and that he was glad to be the savior of their lives, as well as the lives of the Egyptians, under the providential guidance which sent him to Egypt. It is assumed by Bible scholars that if Joseph typically represented Christ and his church, exalted to kingdom honors, so Joseph's brethren would represent the Jews, and the Egyptians represent the remainder of mankind. If this be true, it tells us that neither Jews nor Gentiles have aught to fear from the glorious exaltation of Messiah. On the contrary, the glorious one who was crucified premeditates a great feast of fat things for the whole world, including his brethren who sold him to be crucified. The strength of Joseph centered in his knowledge of the divine promise made to Abraham. Surely a knowledge of God's plan seems indispensable. Trust in God was the secret of faithfulness in all the worthy ones of the past. The same principle still holds true. It seems true, as sometimes charged, that lawlessness is growing in proportion as higher criticism destroys faith in the Bible and its promises. When later the Israelites moved into Egypt, we see the faith of Joseph manifested in his dying request. He said, God will surely visit you and bring you out of this land, Egypt, into the land, Canaan, which he sware to Abraham. He was solicitous that his bones be carried with the Israelites into Canaan. Joseph's various experiences seem to Bible students to typify those of Jesus and his church in suffering and in subsequent glory and honor.